Hello, I'm David Saston with 98.9, brought to you by interest.co.nz. This week, everything you need to know in 90 seconds at 9 o'clock, with news of more Chinese stimulus on the way. But first, in Canada, an official housing agency is warning over the risks of very high household debt-to-income ratios. It exceeds 200% in both Vancouver and Toronto, and is over 170% nationally, they say. New Zealand's national debt-to-income ratio is 124% and only marginally higher than what it was 10 years ago. Overnight, the ECB said it will formally end its $2.6 trillion QE bond buying program on December the 31st. However, it also said it will keep reinvesting the existing stimulus reservoir for years, bolstering an EU economy which is facing both an unexpected slowdown and new political turmoil. Yesterday, the Shanghai Stock Exchange closed up strongly, up 1.2%. Tokyo was up 1% and Hong Kong rose 1.3%. But these gains didn't flow through to European markets, nor have they been reflected on Wall Street, where levels are lower in midday trade today. And in the US, their monthly federal budget statement is about to be released, showing that the deficit rose from $100 billion in October to almost $200 billion in November, and 40% higher than the same month a year ago. The head of the Chinese Central Bank was out talking up more economic support to weigh against the economic headwinds they're facing. This is a public piece of a government-wide program to counter downward pressures. And staying in China, authorities there are detaining Canadians in reprisal for the arrest of the Huawei CFO in Canada on sanctions-busting charges. They're paying the price for offending the PLA's investment in its Huawei enterprise. Yesterday, the Australian Tax Office released its 2017 Tax Transparency Report, showing that one in four of Australia's largest companies paid no tax last year. But the news isn't all bad. Corporate tax revenues are up $7.4 billion this year, and the prior tax losses that allowed companies to shelter current profits are being used up fast, so fast that next year corporate tax take is expected to rise very sharply. And all this is happening without any changes to their tax laws. US Treasury 10-year yield is unchanged at 2.91%, but their 2-10 curve has risen to just over 15 basis points. Gold is a little lower today at $1,243 an ounce. US oil prices are a little changed again today at just under $52 a barrel, while the Brent benchmark is just under $61 a barrel. And the Kiwi dollar is unchanged at 68.6 US cents. On the cross rates, were also stable at 94.9 Aussie cents and 60.4 Euro cents. That puts the TWI down to 73.3. I'm David Chaston. That was 90 at 9, brought to you by interest.co.nz.